Hey guys, Jake from 8020 Automotive here. Today we're going to be talking about P0332 fault codes. A P0332 code is going to read knock sensor 2 circuit low input bank 2. That is not a very friendly sounding engine code. So in this video, I'm going to go ahead and walk you guys through what knock and knock sensors are. And then from there, we'll go ahead and talk about some symptoms, causes, and teach you how to properly diagnose and determine what the issue is that's causing your P0332 fault code and how to fix it. So first off, this engine code is related to knock sensors. Before we go ahead and jump into what the causes and fixes are, it's helpful to understand what engine knock is and understand what these knock sensors do. Engine knock is what happens when the fuel inside the combustion chamber ignites too early in the combustion process or ignites unevenly. When the fuel ignites too early, this causes significant pressure spikes within the combustion chamber that then lead to excessive vibrations or pinging sounds that come from the engine. And it ultimately can lead to some serious and significant damage with your pistons, your rods, and your bearings. Engine knock is not good, and it's something that can lead to very serious problems. With respect to engine knock, it typically occurs from a few things. The first one is from running too low of an octane fuel. The second one is from getting extremely hot or high combustion temperatures, which could happen if your engine's overheating or if your cooling system is not working properly. And then the third thing is from having extremely aggressive timing, which usually is not going to be a driver-related issue unless you're running a heavily modified car. So ultimately, make sure you're running the proper octane fuel and make sure that your cooling system works and your engine's not overheating, and you can reduce the likelihood of knock. But if you have a P0332 code, you obviously have some sort of issue going on within the knock system. The knock sensors are bolted directly to the engine block, and their whole job is to detect the vibrations that occur when engine knock happens and report those vibrations back to the engine's computer to say, hey, we're experiencing engine knock. And then that causes the engine's computer to basically dial back timing. And what that'll do is allow the fuel inside the combustion chamber to burn a little bit later in the combustion process. And that's going to lower the pressure within the combustion chamber, slow down combustion, and ultimately prevent knock or pre-detonation. So that brings us to signs and symptoms of a P0332 fault code. Generally, if you experience engine knock, it's going to happen once, twice, a few times. The engine's going to recognize it from these knock sensors, and then it is going to dial timing back, which is going to fix the problem. Your engine's going to be totally drivable. You're not going to have any issues, but what it is going to do by dialing back that timing is it is going to decrease performance. You're going to have less acceleration. You'll lose a bit of fuel economy. But ultimately, if you're not aggressively getting on the gas pedal, you probably won't notice that you have slightly decreased performance. It is a little bit difficult to tell symptoms that go along with this, just because if you experience knock, the engine is immediately going to try to fix it because we don't want knock and the engine's programmed to prevent it. So let's bring all of that back to what the heck causes a P0332 fault code. Now, an important thing to denote is that a P0332 code doesn't necessarily mean that you have had engine knock. It just means that you have a low input signal coming from one of the knock sensors. Essentially, what that means is the engine's computer is getting a weak signal or no signal at all from the knock sensor. So basically, the knock sensor is not working properly, and the engine's computer recognizes that, and it's basically giving you a code saying, hey, there's something going on with this knock sensor, and so it's going to go ahead and dial timing back just to prevent any potential engine knock, but it doesn't mean that any has occurred yet. So the good thing is all of the potential causes from this error code point directly to the knock sensor itself. Ultimately, getting a low input signal means that there is some type of electrical issue going on with the sensor. So one, the sensor is completely failed and it's not sending any information back to the ECM. Potentially it is dirty, gunked up, grimed up to where it just has a weak signal connection. And so it's sending a weak signal to the engine's computer. Third, another possible thing could be that the wiring is bad, the wiring could be shorted out. And so you could have some type of issue within the wiring harness there to where the electrical connection's not good anymore. Or you could have an issue with the electrical ground. And a lot of time that's gonna come from the mounting bolt. Sometimes you just have a lot of dirt and grime around the mounting bolt of the knock sensor. And that can mess with the ground, which then messes with the input signal from the knock sensor. So ultimately, this error code doesn't necessarily mean you have something bad going on with your engine. It just means that your knock sensor has something bad going on with it. So then let's talk about diagnostic steps that we can do to fix a P0332 engine code. Fortunately, this is pretty simple. The first thing that I'd start with is just clearing the code and then seeing if it comes back up. The reason I do that is because if you get one kind of weak or faulty signal going from the knock sensor to the ECM, it's gonna go ahead and shoot this code up there, but it could have just been a one-off kind of faulty signal that was sent. And so sometimes you might clear it and then it never comes up again before you go start trying to diagnose the problem and find the knock sensors, since they're not always located in a very accessible place in the engine bay. It's good to go ahead and clear the fault code and see if it comes back again. And like I mentioned, this doesn't mean that your engine is actually experiencing knock. And so it's not like by clearing this engine code, you're gonna do any harm. We just wanna see if it's gonna go ahead and come back, because that will give us a good idea of if there's actually a problem or if this was just a random code that popped up from one occurrence. If it comes back, then you probably have an issue with the knock sensor signal. And so from here, we're gonna wanna go ahead and locate it, inspect it, make sure there's not any issues with the grounding or mounting bolt, make sure the wiring all looks good, there's nothing interrupting the wiring. And then, you know, we might wanna go ahead and pull it out and clean it and see if cleaning it will fix some of the electrical contacts and make the signal coming from it better again. Ultimately, if you're gonna do that, you can either, you know, clean it, plug it back in, or just go ahead and replace the whole sensor. At the end of the day, all of the problems with this fault code point specifically to that sensor, and so your best bet's to go ahead and clean it or replace it, and that should hopefully fix the issue. That will get your engine running proper timing again. You'll have all of your power and performance back, and all will be good. So that covers it for our video on P0332 fault codes. If you guys found this helpful, please click the like button, subscribe to our channel, and stay tuned for all the future diagnostic videos we have coming.